So I've been talking about, sorry for delay, I've been talking about early improvements in following glaucoma filtering surgery. I think basically everybody talked, the filter fails in three locations on the blocker, into the ostium. Somebody make a small ostium or tight still black suture. The main culprit is the subclinical scarring, the motor cross of failure. So I think already Shagulang told about type, I always call type 0 block because of multicystic and localized and pressure below teens. And the ideal block we only need a block 1 diffuse, low block, elevated block, and posterior block. And the type 2 is again one is an high IOP, try to fail. And the surface contains enlarged blood vessels and a lot of fibrosis. So this is an encapsulated block with a localized, highly elevated downshift and cyst like cavity in the hypertrophic tetanus capsule. The surface is enlarged blood vessels. Mostly happens in 2 to 8 weeks following surgery. Something associated with the lung formation. So the early sign of failure, sometimes the block to be congested and diffuse along the sutures line, more vascularization, a thickened block or more localized block. The thing is, in the late sign is again the block to vascularize and blood thickening will be increased, a large surface and deep vessels become apparent and reduction in the congenital necrosis of process and divisor. The main risk factor for the failure of the block is higher among the patient using AGM. They're not stopping AGM during surgery. They're not supplementing with topical sedative because surgery is high risk for failure. I already know taking sudafaking in the glaucoma and NDH, unsuccessful surgeries and black race to supposed to be some of the risk factors. So I'll be talking about mostly about digital massage and arterial suture lysis, releasing the visible suture for EFP or metamucil injections. And I think they will also talk about needling. And one of the recently seen in the European Glaucoma Society, you consider focal pressure in the case of uncoated filtration shortly after transplantation because it's very important. If you want a good successful later block, it's supposed to need a good block initial postoperative period. And this is the one is always better to check the pressure on day one. Maybe people who don't do. I normally check in a green light, I don't need the fluorescein. I can get the roughly around the pressure is 10, 15, or 20. So you can able to feel pressure more than 20. You can do something massage like this to elevate the block. And try to don't be scared of taking a pressure, giving a massage immediate postoperative period. If you come up on, check the pressure and do it, and look for the blood to form immediately after your massage. And this is the one, this is the massage. I will give you an increasing fluid separation between the flap and subcutaneous tissue. I can do it nearly postoperative period. You can just pressure here, then the surgeon does the filtration, and massage it here to see if blood is elevating. The ideal thing to do before ALS. Before doing suture lysis, you can know how much fluid is coming out from your massage. If the fluid is coming out very early and very minimal massage, you can delay ALS. If it's coming a lot of force, and you can better do suture lysis. In what is recently, I just gone through the study. This can early postoperative interval pressure predict the success following mitomycin C in augmented top and rotocolectomy, and especially in angle to the glaucoma. And the purpose they evaluate association between early and postoperative IOP and determine the early and postoperative IOP to predict the surgical outcome. And what the outcome prediction is IOP in the day 1 is more than 10.5 and IOP in the day 7 is more than 13.5. The related risk of failure was around 4.2. 90% of the confidence was 1.2 to 14.8. The cutoff value was 13.5 meter day 7, achieved accuracy of 80% in predicting success of IOP less than 15. At the same time, the 57% of predicting failure less more than 15 with the medication after surgery, respectively. So what are the conclusions of the study is in the control of early IOP at 13.5 or less, provide a better outcome. So immediate intervention of the surgery has a principal role in maintaining filtration and change the probability of successful and complicated. And this is one more tips of glaucoma for European glaucoma. The blood manipulation of glaucoma can be successfully treated by using acute suppression rather than needling for the short period of time. Okay, so the basically for digital for a lace for a period you can do intensive steroids. Don't worry about giving steroids. We have to give more steroids at least for 3 months. It could be a glaucoma. If the failure, you can also increase up to 6 months once a day. So acute suppression better to start on day 10. If you feel like there's going to be some tenderness, teach patients to give a massage from the downside, and you can see a blood elevating there. You can do a steady fingertip, you can do 100 degree away from a block. Ideally, we say 4 times a day, a 10 second interval, and reassess every visit. And it's ideal for doing before needling. If the patient know how to do massage, even after needling, this would be very useful to have a successful needling. And if there is any high FEMA ACC allergy, try to avoid doing knowledge to myself. As this video, sorry, it's not coming and not playing. Whether it's I was trying to see in my Mac. So it will just be a question from here. As a person, look up and give a 10 question, 4 times a day, a good thing for the filtration. And the laser suture lysis relatively is effective. You can avoid early blood failure. You can extra measure to control your operations. You can selectively laser the subcutaneous sutures, allows the post-operative tightness of intercal pressure, basically increasing the outflow. When to do it, ideally around 7 to 14 days following glaucoma filtration surgery. If you're using mitomycin, you can do more than 14 days. And the two lenses, basically the lens is muscular, the one ideally normally we use. And it has a button on the back side. It has the lenses, the connecting vessels, you can close up the suture, you can fix the glow. Easier for you to control and you can cut the sutures. And normally the laser used, normally uses frequency double LDAC, green laser, by that we do dynamics. You can use the topical anesthesia. And then again, the suture lasers, my video is not working, sorry. You just have to cut the suture, give a massage, see for the spontaneous blood formation, not forming, zero pressure from downside to form the blood. And the power is around 300 to 800 milliwatts and around 550 micrometers spot size. 0.2 second missing durations and never cut more than one suture. This is a diagram drawn by my own point. The colleague at Vasu and excellent the diagrammatic one. You cut the laser, you see the suture lice. Don't cut more than one suture and the complication can be congenital bottom tubes, hepatomy, shallow chamber, detachment, leave from osteo and IPM. And the releasing sutures is effective as I said to suture laces. The timing of release is the same as the suture laces. It's very useful for thick T-knots. You feel like somebody in a pre-operative during this intraoperative, very thick T-knots, and that is very difficult to do a suture lysis. Better to put two, three release sutures. And also, the lasers are not available. Very periphery of the center, the lasers are not available. This is really helpful to achieve a success in your surgery. So again, the video, sorry, it's not working. It just showed how to release the visible suture. And the agents is normally to minimize the post-operative fibrosis, you use your longest acting cigarettes. Don't use Valproate, Lotiprate, don't use Chloramethylone, don't get scared of using a steroid. But in topoclatamy, you can use Dexamethasone, the longer acting steroids to have better success, more frequent and longer time. And can we use in pre-operative, what our artists were saying, better use pre-operative, somebody using more than 3 drugs and using a topoclatamy. And what 5-FU, what antimicrobial is supposed to use is 5-FU and mitomycin C. And 5-FU, you know, is an proven method with type of resistance, the inhibit type of perturbation. Basically, take 0.1 cc, 5 milligram, do next to the blood, don't worry, don't give it away from blood. Now, if you see 100 degree away from blood, now you're giving next to the blood, 8 millimeter from the limbus, you clinically, based on the clinical response. The main problem with the 5-FU injection is the large epithelial effect. So, no, don't allow the 5-FU to leak from your wound, better to massage after your injections. And mitomycin C, you know, it is 100 times better than 5-FU, the more of an endothelial toxicity and concentration is 0.2 to 0.3 milligrams and it inhibit DNA synthesis. Basically, what Devendra told is we use 0.2 milligram for mitomycin C, then we have to take 1.15 cc of mitomycin C, we mix it to 0.12 xylac and we take 0.03 in total and this way. And I think this way we inject 8 millimeters from limbus and try to massage this area and so that they can, the mitomycin won't go to limbus. The blood bleeding, I think they would have told you the three things. One thing is subpenetrable, subscleral, and entering the anterior chamber. So three methods are important. So if you have one more tip, if you want to do a blood bleeding in the injection during a sit-lump, you can bend the needle like this, with a needle cap, so that you get an angulation like this, you can easily get it. So take home point is check the European day one, roughly around 10 millimeter. Day 7, less than 31 millimeter. I think good filtration, the early post-operative period of the topoclatamy is associated with the long-term success. Thank you. So we don't want a blood to be around 20. We don't want your blood to be 6. We better have blood to be around 10. Post-operative diffuse blood is the ideal one to be able for it. Thank you.